everyone, and welcome to my 15th BCR. So today I thought today's review would require someone big, and they don't come any bigger than the Titan who brought the Autobots to Earth in the first place. As usual, the BC scale will be taken into account for both his virtues and for his flaws, and I invite you to follow along. But first and foremost, if you're not a subscriber, please do me a big, huge favor that won't cost you a dime. Please, hit that fabled subscribe button, and make sure to like this video. Here in his arc mode, the last Autobot is a hefty bot. So the first thing you're probably noticing is the awesome artwork in the background, depicting the arc giving Megatron the what for. So that right there is worthy of a point boost of 3 on the scale. His vehicle mode is a true homage to the actual shuttle that we see in the Transformers 3 episode pilot from Griffin Bacall's Sunbow and Marvel Productions. So you gotta give Hasbro their props. Another 3 points for craftsmanship. While it's the same ship that you see in the comics from Marvel in that era, it's of a quite different color and shape, but that's where the name Ark is actually taken from. So thank you, Bob Budiansky, for that. So on the display here, we have our main guest, Ann Teletran 1, whose video you can find in the link above. Also, we're going to be going over some 3D printed pieces that I downloaded to give him a solid look. Welcome to the 15th Spectacular Blue Cliff Review, hosted by your good pal, future voice actor. Now, on with the show. Here on our display, as he looks without his 3D prints, so basically as he looked 15 minutes out of the box. His landing gear, as you see here on the bottom, makes for a cautious way to display him if you've got sensitive surfaces, so that yields a substantial 5 never points, which puts us at 11 on a scale that is aiming for 30 as the goal. Now, as we take out the tower from its resting space, we have to take away 1 point for coming without any filler for the gap and back. But it's still a great gimmick. Let's see that again. These 3D printed pieces are available to download from cgtrader.com. Range exposed back gaps on the arc have a 2-point penalty to them, which we can remedy with my latest pieces that I downloaded. Gap fillers for the rear of the arc. Now, I've seen the Toy Hacks decals and Repro labels has to offer, so it's a good thing that it's not a permanent filler, because it has great potential. So we'll give back those 2 points, putting us back at 10 total. Now, these smaller components are a lot of fun. Once they're put in, your imagination can weaponize the boarding chute that was part of the set as well. Observe, as Optimus tests out the Red Alert protocol for a Romulan invasion drill. Here on the back are the main thrusters in my favorite color, blue. And here you can see the filler that I spoke of earlier. These ports will come in handy for the ignition sequence. Who are like me that can't go a trip without extra Energon or a cherry buy, you're in luck, as the emergency hatch here allows for a secret space which earns another 2 never points. Now as we turn him to the front, the paint job it sports tickles the mind, with its corrosion and metallic blue in strategic places. In the center of the ship is the main bridge. The window is neat, but does not give you a good view of what goes on inside, which takes back those 2 last never points. But since the paint applications make the ship pop, we're going to give those never points right back. Now, let's get him ready for the big T formation, which starts with retracting the beak of the ship and unfastening the panels below, which will free the hatch to the bridge. And here's one of my pet peeves with this figure in action. These panels fall off easy, and it looks like Nicole agrees with me, as she is savagely deducting 3 never points. Luckily, they're easy to put back together, so that's why Solon is going to give back a point as a silver lining to this bad panel cloud. Standing him upright, we'll begin with the transformation, But since the optimist that came with the arc is painted, Solon is authorized to give out another never point. And we will withdraw mainframe from the bridge and put him to the side. Now, you fold these two side panels inward and double fold the other two on each other. This will be what clips the front to his torso. Unpacking his arms and hiding away the tower are the next steps. Now, this drives my folks crazy, but listen to this. The ratchets on this guy are nice, loud, and crisp, showing that it's well engineered and that's going to last for a while. So Nicole will once again pass out another 2 points as we speed through the rest of the transformation process, which is not as difficult as it seems. Just follow along. Here in robot mode, we have the last Autobot, who in my opinion was the perfect choice for this Titan-class figure. Apparently, my little Nilivan is a fan of this as well, as she's showering him with 3 points worth of pixie dust. A very useful part of this mode, if you have as many small bulky 3D parts as I do, or accessories, they can be stored away like pennies and candy in cannabis, like the Marx Brothers did with grouch bags around their necks when they were kids. These two big panels here were difficult to fasten onto him, but they hide the touch of gray that you see in his legs. And on the front, you see the thrusters that carry over in vehicle mode. Now, I've done a few pics of this on Facebook because it is a lot of fun. Open up his chest cover, and you've got a meme machine. Go ahead. I'm going to give you a couple of chances with these two minifigures, an Autobot Mini Spy and Rung, aka Primus. Or he can just light the Autobot's darkest hour as the next Prime. As long as we're on the subject of lighting, my favorite feature is his eyes, which, like mainframe, are engineered to take advantage of light piping, which my little Nilivan is going to reward with 3 more never points. Now, his robot mode hands are able to hold objects like the golden discs, and even his own instructions. For that, we're going to give him the 2 never points that he deserves. Another thing that's great about the Ark is also the crew that he comes with, Mainframe and Sky Spy, along with the golden discs, the Geoglobe, and the Mini Optimus are part of the figure's appeal, which earns him another tri-point boost. Nilivan's going to port in some of the Ark's fellow bots for a size comparison, keeping in mind that due to mass shifting, they won't be the scale. So looking at the box art once again, it is very colorful and well done. It's a real work of art. And due to truth in advertising, he can actually make Megatron plead for mercy.
But after all that he has seen, the last Autobot is made of sterner stuff. He killed Optimus Prime, and he is not gonna let him get away with it.
The fact that this scene can be replicated, my beloved AJ is gonna bless him with 5 well-deserved never points. Thanks, Halo Top. Now, on to the Blue Cliff scale to tally. Thank you for joining us for this week's Blue Cliff Review. Also coming soon are my interviews with Transformers scribe Bob Budiansky and Rhinox's voice actor Richard Newman. And if you're a trivia buff like me, tune into my pal Orion Patz's channel to put your knowledge to the test.
Transform and fly out.